Okay, today we are discuss about new problem on I section has the following dimension in millimeter, that is bottom flange of 300 by 100 millimeter, top flange of 150 by 50 millimeter and web of 300 by 50 millimeter. Determine the mathematically the position of center of gravity of the section. What we have to find out the center of gravity of the provided I section. Now here this I section is not symmetrical about XX axis. It is only symmetrical about YY axis. In this condition, what we have to do, we have to find out corresponding area of the these individual rectangles. Similarly, we have to find out the center of gravity of that individual rectangles corresponding with the bottom or at the top. Now here, this is nothing but what? Flange. The horizontal element, it is called a flange. We called it as a flange. And vertical member under the such section, we called it as a web. We called it as a web. And this one is the top flange. And this one is the bottom flange. This one is the bottom flange. Okay, now here these dimensions of bottom flange, top flange and web is already provided over here. Now let us see how to solve this problem. Now this I section is symmetrical about YY axis. This section is symmetrical about YY axis. Now let us start with bottom flange. Okay, let us find out the area of the bottom flange first and then the location of that bottom flange from the bottom, CG location from the bottom. Now here, as we see here from the geometry, the length and the width over here is 300 by 100. 300 by 100, it means that 30,000 millimeter square is the area of that particular flange. Now we have to locate the CG of that particular geometry from the bottom, from the bottom. Now let us see how to solve this one. Now here, this distance, we called it as a Y1 and it will be 100 divided by 2. That's why this distance will be of 50 millimeter over here. This distance is 100 by 2. It means that 50 millimeter is the Y1. And at this location, the CG of that particular figure is lies. Okay. And already we know that it is symmetrical about YY axis. YY axis and XX axis is intersecting at this location. That's why the CG of that particular bottom flange is located at this distance of 50 millimeter from the bottom. Now, similarly, for the next web portion, for this web portion, we have to find out the area. Now, here from the geometry, the length and the width 350. That's why multiply by 350 will we get a 15,000 millimeter square is the area of this web. And the location of the CG of this particular rectangle that we have to locate over here. And as we know that it is located at half of this 300, it means that from here to here, this distance is of 150, but we have to measure this distance from this to the bottom. It means that we have to add this 100 millimeter over here. It means that 150 plus this 100, it becomes a 250. This 100 plus this 300 by 2, it means that 150, it becomes a 250 millimeter. This distance is from the bottom. Okay, now if you see here, this distance is Y2 from bottom to the location over here. Now similarly, the third one, this top flange, the area and the CG location that we have to find out from the geometry over here, the area 150 multiplied by 50 and the CG is located at, as we know that the CG will be located over here, half of this 150 is located at, at a distance of 25 millimeter, but we have to measure this distance from this to this. That's why this 50 plus this 300 plus this 200 plus this 100, 25 plus this 300 plus this 100, how much this will be? 425. This distance will be 425 from the bottom. The distance we called it as y3. This distance is of y3, and what we have found it out over here. That's why the area of the top flange, 150 into 50, it becomes a 7500 millimeter square, and y3 is equal to 100 plus 300 plus 50 by 2, it becomes a 425 millimeter. Now once you will be getting all these area a1, a2, a3 corresponding distance from the bottom, y1, y2, y3, now put all these values in this formula. Y bar is equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 divided by a1 plus a2 plus a3. Now as we have calculated, a1 is of 13,000, y1 is of 50, a2 is of 15,000, and y2 is of 250, a3 is of 7,500, and y3 is of 425. And put the areas, all areas together, a1 plus a2 plus a3, 13,000, 15,000, and 7,500. Now let us calculate these terms, and you'll be getting, I will be put the bracket for the upper portion and lower portion separately. Now this 30,000 multiplied by 50 plus this 15,000 multiplied by 250 plus 7,500 multiplied by 425, bracket complete, divide by again bracket this 30,000 plus 15,000 plus 7,500, bracket complete, is equal to, now let us check it out, 160.71, correct, 116.71 millimeter. Now this is nothing but what? Your distance from the bottom. This is nothing but what? The distance from the bottom. Now if you locate this, it will be lies at, this will be lies at anywhere over here. It may be lies over here, x6, and this distance is of 160.7 millimeter, and intersection of xx axis and intersection of this yy axis is nothing but what? Center of gravity of this I section, center of gravity of the I section, which is located at this location. Okay, and you may find it out this distance also from the top also. What we have found it out, this y1, y2 and y3 from the bottom, if instead of this from the bottom, if we have measured this distance from the top, we'll be getting this distance y bar from the top. Okay, answer will be same, only the location is from the top in that particular case. But what we have solved this problem from the distance, we have taken all these distances from the bottom, that's why this CG will be getting from the bottom. That's why this distance is from the bottom. Y bar is equal to 16.7 millimeter. Okay, this one is the symmetrical I section. Symmetrical about Y axis, not symmetrical about X axis. Unsymmetrical I section, the problem we have solved. Now similarly, now let us see center of gravity for unsymmetrical section. How to solve this problem? Now let us see. Now here, find the center of gravity of unequal angle section of 100 millimeter by 18 millimeter by 20 millimeter. Now here, if you see here, this geometry is called it as angle section. Angle means L shape. angle section, unequal angle. Unequal angle means what? The leg of this side and the leg of this side is different. Here this leg is of 100 millimeter and this leg is of 80 millimeter. If both these values are same, then in that condition we called it as an equal angle. But these are unequal, that's why this section is called unequal angle section. Okay, and the dimensions provided here is one leg is of 100 and another leg is of 80, and the thickness is of 20 millimeter. If you see here, this thickness is of 20 millimeter. And what we have to find out the CG of that particular section. Now, as we know that we have divided this angle section into two geometries, two rectangles. First rectangle. Now let us find out the area of this rectangle. This dimension is of 100, thickness is of 20, 100 by 20, you will be getting 2000 millimeter square is the area. Now again, the CG of that particular figure that we have to locate about this XX axis and about this YY axis. Now to find out this, what we have to make this look at here, this distance is of Y bar or Y1. 100 by 2, that's why this distance is Y1, 100 by 2, you'll be getting 15 millimeter. Now similarly, we have to find out X distance, that's why this distance is of X1, and this will be half of this 20, that's why 20 by 2, it becomes a 10 millimeter. These are the, this one is the area of the figure, and this one is the location of your CG of that particular figure, and it is located at this point. Okay, this is located, CG of rectangle number one is located at this particular point, and the coordinate of that particular point is about X axis is 10 millimeter and about Y axis this will be the 50 millimeter. Now similarly we have to work out these quantities for the rectangle number two. Now the area of the rectangle number two, how to find out this? Now out of this 80 millimeter, already we are used this 20 millimeter in first rectangle. It means that the remaining length will be of 60 millimeter over here. It means that this 80 minus 20 multiply by this thickness is of 20. That's why 60 into 20, you'll be getting the 1200 millimeter square is the area number two, rectangle number two. Area of the rectangle number two is 1200 millimeter square. Now similarly, we have to find out the CG location, as here what we have found out for the rectangle number one, similarly we have to locate for the rectangle number two. Now to find out this one again, now if you see here, this distance from the bottom, you'll be getting the Y2, and Y2 will be of this 20 by 2. 20 by 2. It means that 10 millimeter will be the distance of Y2. Now similarly, X2, how to find out X2 from the left side to up to this one. Out of this 60, out of this, as we have seen, this distance is of 60, 50, 60 by 2. Will be the CG location, but we have to measure this distance from the left face. That's why we have to add this 20 also. That's why 20 plus 60 by 2 means 30. 20 plus 30 becomes a 50. It means that this distance is of 50 millimeter. Okay, it means that the CG of this particular figure is lies over here, and the location, it means that the centroid of section number two or rectangle number two is located at about X axis 50 millimeter and about Y axis 10 millimeter. Now once you'll be getting all this area and the corresponding coordinate of X1, Y1, X2, Y2 of that particular rectangles respectively, we have to simply put this all this value in the formulae X bar and Y bar. As we know that the formula of X bar is A1 X1 plus A2 X2 divided by A1 plus A2. Because here only two areas are considered, that's why the formula will be limited for the area number one and area number two. Now area number 1 is of 2000, put this 2000. X1 is of 10, put this value 10 over here. Now area number 2 is of 1200. X2 is of 50, put this value over here. And again put the A1 and A2 over here. And let us calculate these terms. Now let us calculate. Now put the value bracket 2000 multiply by 10 plus 1200 multiply by 50 bracket complete divided by again 2000 plus 1200 bracket complete is equal to 25 millimeter. It means that your X bar will be 20 millimeter for the together these two rectangles. It forms an unequal angle section, and the CG of that particular location about X axis is 25 millimeter. Now similarly for the Y bar, now put the bracket this 2000 multiply by 50, Y1 is of 50, Y1 is of 50. Now look at here, area 2000, this area 1200. Now here Y1 is of 50, put this value over here. Y2 is of 10, put this value over here. Again areas are same, only we have to change Y1 and Y2 over here instead of this X1 and X2. You'll be getting this Y bar. Now let us calculate again this plus this 1200 into 10 bracket complete divided by again into bracket 2000 plus 1200, will be getting Y bar 35 millimeter. Okay, it means that the CG of this particular section is lies at coordinate, if you are drawing and coordinate about this X bar and Y bar, X bar, X means horizontal distance, at a distance of 25 millimeter. It means that it is located anywhere over here, and this distance is of 25, and another distance is of 35. It means that it is located anywhere here, and this distance is of 35 Y bar, and the intersection of these two is nothing but what, the CG of that particular geometry. Unequal angle, it is located over here. And if you see here from the calculation, it is observed that the CG of unequal angle is located outside the figure. It may happen in many of the geometries, the CG is located outside the figure. Okay, by such a way we are able to solve these problems by using this simple formula X bar and Y bar, and we are able to find out the center of gravity of the any type of an unequal, equal, or any type of an figure which is made up of the number of combinations. Okay.